President Ronald Reagan was taken through a massive reinforced steel door into the very heart of Cheyenne Mountain, where the headquarters of the North American Aerospace Defense Command monitored the skies of America. The bunker organization was the first and last line of defense against an intercontinental ballistic missile attack. Encouraged by the complex surveillance consoles, giant computers, interactive maps, and dozens of operators, Reagan asked what the U.S. defensive options were in case of a missile attack. The answer was chilling to hear, even for the president. There was nothing. The only course of action, if deterrence failed, was retaliation. 40 years later, the U.S. ability to take enemy ICBMs from the sky remains practically the same, with even the formidable $40 billion Ground-Based Midcourse Defense System only showcasing an average 55% success rate in intercepting Cold War-era missiles. Even so, the ICBMs Russia is testing today far surpass the technology on which the GMD system was tested. Unveiled in 2018, the Avangard hypersonic glide vehicle is Russia's fearful new intercontinental nuclear-capable missile, a weapon so fast it can reach 20 times the speed of sound and avert incoming interceptors in real time. Whether the superweapon is as powerful as Vladimir Putin claims, or if it is merely a Russian bluff, remains to be seen. In the meantime, as Reagan did decades ago, the American people are left wondering how to defend their nation against such an earth-shattering menace. Hypersonic ICBM. Stopping an incoming supersonic intercontinental ballistic missile is a daunting, desperate task. Monitoring agencies have only seconds to identify the launch, trace its trajectory, and inform the President of the United States, who must determine whether to launch an interception in a split-second decision. The U.S. Defense Network must have anti-missile equipment relatively close to the site where the ICBM has been launched, and then hope that the countless variables that can turn the interception into a failure roll in their favor. As one military official put it, it's like, quote, striking a bullet with another bullet in space. The complexity of the whole affair is part of why the U.S. and its allies have been forced to rely on nuclear deterrence as their primary defense against a possible nuclear attack. Despite short and medium-range anti-missile solutions, like Israel's Iron Dome being highly reliable, things become exponentially more challenging with large missiles with speeds of up to 3,682.89 miles per hour. As such, intercepting hypersonic ICBMs that can reach speeds of 15,345 miles per hour is impossible with current technology, and the nature of such missiles has led the world into another dreadful arms race that, if we are to believe Russia's claims, the United States is losing. In March of 2018, Vladimir Putin surprised the world by revealing that Russia had two operational hypersonic weapons, the Kinjal, a fast, air-launched missile capable of striking targets up to 1,200 miles away, and something worse, the Avangard, designed to be attached to a new Sarmat intercontinental ballistic missile before maneuvering towards its targets at speeds of Mach 20. Russian media have also asserted that nuclear warheads for both weapons are already being produced, and that the Avangard missile has already been successfully tested 3,000 miles across Siberia. Numerous American experts have cast doubt on Putin's bold claims, assuring that there's no evidence that the systems can perform as advertised. Nevertheless, the Pentagon is taking the threat seriously. Even if the Avangard is not an immediate menace, it soon could be. The Avangard hypersonic glide vehicle. In his ominous address to the Russian High Command and the media, President Vladimir Putin described the Avangard as an intercontinental ballistic missile capable of traveling at a speed of Mach 20 and hitting its targets like a falling meteor. The dictator added, quote, "The weapon is capable of performing sharp maneuvers on its way to targets, making it absolutely invulnerable for any missile defense system." The Avangard is a hypersonic glide vehicle launched to orbit using an intercontinental ballistic missile. The projectile travels through space towards its destination before gliding down towards its target at hypersonic speeds. During its documented test over Siberia, the Avangard flew inside a UR-100NU ICBM, and according to Russian media reporting the event the following day, the avant-garde re-entered Earth at a speed of Mach 27, or a staggering 20,760 miles per hour. If this estimation is accurate, there's no weapon on Earth capable of intercepting an object moving at such speeds. The weapon is allegedly designed using advanced and classified composite materials capable of sustaining temperatures of over 2,000 degrees Celsius and the overwhelming friction caused by the hypersonic speeds during re-entry. The avant-garde hypersonic glide missile can reportedly change course and altitude at very high speeds, making them virtually invincible, according to Putin, who also compares the military breakthrough of this development to the creation of the first artificial satellite on Earth, the iconic Sputnik. The Russian reports coincide with Pentagon intelligence, which also describes a high-speed missile being tested by Russia in late 2018. However, American officials have not confirmed the specific details claimed by Putin. Even so, the fact that Russia could now be armed with hypersonic, nuclear-capable intercontinental missiles is a top concern for the U.S. Defense Department, which has lately multiplied its efforts to produce a new generation of American hypersonic ICBMs to deter the threat posed by Putin's Russia. Unprepared. Many critics of the Russian regime have expressed doubt about the avant-garde program, citing Russia's long track record of menacing bluffs regarding weapons of mass destruction. One engineer working on American ICBMs even told the New York Times that, quote, "Their test record is more like ours. It's had a small number of flight test successes." Nevertheless, even if the chances are low, Russia having operational, maneuverable hypersonic ICBMs would mean they have already surpassed the U.S. military in that respect. The dreadful possibility has forced many U.S. congresspeople to urge the Pentagon to accelerate its development of new hypersonic missiles capable of standing head-to-head with the Russian avant-garde. Numerous politicians have interpreted Russia's claim as a clear sign that Washington has fallen behind Moscow in the hypersonic missile race. Therefore, they are pressuring the Department of Defense to give the utmost urgent priority to the continuous development of American maneuverable hypersonic ICBMs in the hopes that the technology can serve as a deterrent to a Russian attack. Representative Mike Turner, a ranking member of the House Intelligence Committee, said, quote, "We're behind our adversaries in hypersonics," as he urged the House of Representatives to take immediate action on the national security issue. Piercing through the Russian propaganda veil is impossible. As such, knowing for sure if they are ahead in the hypersonic missile race will not happen for a while. Still, America must take the threats very seriously and prepare to respond as if every single claim is valid. Even if most evidence points to a bluff, underestimating Russia could be a catastrophic mistake. The U.S. is now conducting its own series of hypersonic ICBM tests, but Russia might have up to a 4-year advantage with the avant-garde, and American missiles don't seem to have the ability to swiftly evade interceptors like the avant-garde claims to have. With the conflict in Ukraine escalating rapidly, the entire world is hoping the United States' recent developments are enough to deter the Russians from further escalating and even deciding to use the avant-garde in the Eastern European conflict. Thank you for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, click on your screen to check out another of our Dark Documentaries channels, where we delve into the most fascinating battles and powerful weapons in modern history. We publish new content regularly, so stay tuned.